When is the best time to take MOTS-c? So as with anything in life, there's timing and there's dosing that are really important. And MOTS-c, what a lot of people don't realize is that you can take it at a certain time of day and you'll multiply its benefits. Whereas if you take it at the wrong time of day, you may not see the same outcomes. And so in this video, I'm going to dive into all the pathways that MOTS-c can activate and why there's a specific time in the day that you want to take MOTS-c. So stick around to the end of this video and you're going to have the confidence to know exactly when to take MOTS-c. So when is the best time to take MOTS-c? Well, think about the circadian rhythms. So MOTS-c, it activates mitochondria, which gives you energy. So would you want to take it right before you fall asleep? Probably not. And however, there are some caveats. I do have some clients who have this reverse polarity and they do better at night, but that's such a rare thing. It's like 1 in 1,000. But when you take it in the morning, what I notice is that I have better energy. I have better mental clarity. I feel like tackling my workout instead of just kind of slugging it out. I really want to get after it. And so MOTS-c, the best time to take it is when you wake up. You don't necessarily need to be fasting, but you will notice that if you can take it first thing in the morning in a fasted state, and especially take it with methylene blue and then get outside and just go for a light walk. And for those of you who we have you on a time-restricted eating window, it's okay to take it on an empty stomach and you can wait a few hours after you've taken it. For those of you, we don't necessarily want you to have a tight eating window because if you fast too long, it causes more stress on your adrenals and more cortisol and more weight gain and all those things. Then you can eat 30 minutes after you take it. And the beautiful thing about MOTS-c is when you use it on training days, so if we have your dose at 3 times per week, let's say we do 10 milligrams, you're going to take total throughout the week, and you may be doing 30 units, 30 units, and 30 units, or 33 would be the exact. Make sure you read the dosing. We will have it in your program design. Make sure that you follow that because there's different milligrams per milliliter dosing that you want to be aware of. But typically we'll be dosing 10 to 15 milligrams per week, or we'll start on a microdose, which is 5 milligrams per week, based on what your labs look like. But when you can do this on the days that you're exercising, you're going to get more benefits of exercise. So remember, exercise is one of the great ways that your body causes an expression of MOTS-c, because MOTS-c is one of the most powerful exercise mimetics. It's probably the closest thing that we know of as exercise in a bottle. But it also, when you exercise, you have your body's own expression of MOTS-c. It increases by 400 to 500%. And when you activate the same genes with the peptide, you'll get an even greater expression of it. Here's just a little cherry on top. You don't have to do this by any means. But if you can jump into the sauna after you've worked out, let's say you work out for 30 minutes, you can jump into a sauna about 170 degrees, and you stay in there for 20 minutes, you'll get an even greater expression of MOTS-c. Now, you're probably wondering, like, well, what are the benefits of MOTS-c, and why would I want so much expression? Well, remember, when you've got any kind of metabolic disease, and when you're trying to get ahead of this thing called aging, we want you as healthy as possible every year, getting healthier and healthier. And so MOTS-c, if you look at the pathways that it's activated, I find it's really fascinating because MOTS-c, it's been proven to promote fat loss. It helps with a healthy body composition. It improves insulin sensitivity. It also enhances your physical performance, your energy levels. It supports bone health. There's studies that find that regulates bone metabolism through the OPG ratio and AMPK. It's anti-inflammatory, has analgesic effects, so you don't feel the same amount of pain when you're exercising. It also protects against oxidative damage and cellular stress. It promotes healthy aging and longevity. It increases cognition. It also improves immune regulation. And one of the great things that does this is through this pathway called AMPK, or AMP activated protein kinase, and that is your central energy sensor. So I don't know if you've had those days where you're just like, man, I feel so tired. I slept fine. I don't feel like I'm sick, but I'm just tired. And one of the things that happens is we have this central energy sensor, and if that energy sensor is low, then you're going to have more glucose that's free circulating in your blood, which is what you don't want. You're going to have more oxidation. You're going to have more oxidative stress. You're going to have more inflammation. But when you have this energy sensor where the energy is high, what you're doing is you'll flush out all the old cells. So one of the fastest ways to remove the things that you don't want is through exercise. It's called autophagy. Now, a lot of us in the past, we thought that fasting was the best way to get rid of those underperforming cells. And what we realize is exercise is actually more effective than fasting for autophagy. And if you want to increase your results from your exercise, then you add MOTS-c because you're going to activate that energy sensor, which triggers mitophagy and autophagy. It also increases your glucose utilization, so you get glucose into the cell faster, so it fixes that insulin resistance, so you're not so hungry after you work out. And then it also decreases inflammation so that you recover faster. One of the pathways called the CK2 kinase pathway is involved in that muscle glucose uptake. When you have this CK2 kinase pathway activated, your muscles will actually stay more hydrated, so you won't get the cramping. It also works on the MAPK pathways. So it's ERK, JNK, P38, and then the CFOS. And what these pathways do is it inhibits the stress and the inflammatory response in your body. That's one of the ways you have more of these kind of analgesic effects. You get more endorphins when you exercise. I know you guys are like, I gotta go try this when I exercise. Maybe I love exercise. I can tell you that this single peptide has helped a lot of our clients just really fall in love with exercise again. We have this roadmap, it's called your 10-year roadmap. And one of the central pieces of this thinking tool is helping you find physical activities that you love that you can always do. It was a tool that I had support from Dan Sullivan, founder of Strategic Coach. He's got the goal to live to be 156. And what we realized in the thinking is you want to have things that you love doing throughout your whole life that you'll be able to do as a 100-year-old. So we created the Fitness 50 Benchmarks. And these things, you can go to agelessfuture.com and you can get my Fitness 50 Benchmarks. You can get that free tool and then give yourself a test. But use the MOTS-c because you'll love doing the test. It also works on the NF-kappa-beta pathway. It inhibits this pathway via the AMPK pathway. It also reduces inflammation and also reduces the osteoclastogenesis. So that's where it supports the bones. There's more, but wait, it works on the GLUT-4. So if you guys know what GLUT-4 is, GLUT-4 is where the cells can take in glucose without the presence of insulin. And this pathway was groundbreaking. When we learned about it about 15 years ago, we said, oh, exercise activates GLUT-4, so you can actually get sugar into the cells with no need of insulin being around. And MOTS-c does the same thing. It helps regulate the expression of the genes involved in GLUT-4. It also helps with glucose transportation, metabolism, and immune modulation. And then I'm going to tell you one more on this, just so you know that this is a phenomenal peptide, but it works on the proteostasis pathway. And if you've heard any of my other videos, like you may want to look at the videos on muscle growth and peptides for muscle building. We talk about ACE-31. We talk about some of the cool peptides like growth hormone peptides. But proteostasis is really important because that regulates the protein folding. And we have adequate protein folding and stress responses when you're under metabolic stress, then your body can actually build muscle instead of just get stressed and have this oxidative reaction in your body. So MOTS-c is pretty powerful. So here's a patient who came to see us. What happened after being on MOTS-c? We had this 47-year-old female patient. She's an entrepreneur who complained of morning fatigue, slow recovery, weight plateau despite a clean diet and doing all the right things. Hemoglobin A1C was 5.8. She did not want to get on the GLP-1s. And it was fine because she said, look, I have friends who got really sick on them. So we said, let's try MOTS-c. It's really powerful. And it may do the trick for you, but you're going to have to do a little more work on your side. And she said, no problem, I'll do it. We put her on a high protein, low inflammatory diet. She also did some regenerative medicine with us because she had some knee issues. And we had her on the 10 milligrams of MOTS-c. And it was injected subcutaneously Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. So 10 milligrams total throughout the week. She was able to do a little more intermittent fasting. And we gave her trace minerals, electrolytes, and then a mitochondrial support blend that had the urolithin A. It had the methylene blue. And then we also had her on SS31, cycled on the days that she was not on the MOTS-c. And what she found is that when we retested her labs just 90 days later, her A1C dropped from 5.8 to 5.4. She lost 9.6 pounds of mostly visceral fat. About 3 pounds of that was the visceral fat confirmed. She was using her in-body scan, so not as accurate as the DEXA scan. I realized that. Her energy restored in the morning. She increased her workouts to 4 times a week and then 5 times, and then she's working out every day. Her HRV, according to her Oura Ring, improved by 18 points. And so the HRV is your heart rate variability, and it shows the balance of stress in your sympathetic and parasympathetic nervous system. So that means she was recovering better. She said, "I feel like my body's finally working with me and not against me." In a clinical study, they've actually looked at MOTS-c and how it could help in NASH, or non-alcoholic fatty liver disease. In this clinical trial, it was conducted by Cobar, which is a biotechnology company, and they wanted to see, first of all, is it safe? And secondly, is it effective in patients with this condition? Because what we're seeing is there's a lot of patients who don't drink alcohol, but yet we look at their labs and they have elevated hemoglobin A1C, they have elevated ALT and AST markers, and they have elevated triglycerides. And then when they go get the scan on their liver, sure enough, they're diagnosed with NASH, or non-alcoholic steatosis, hepatitis. So it's where the liver actually starts to get fatty. And the problem with that is, just like you get a swollen ankle, your ankle doesn't work very well. And it's same with the liver. That NASH can turn into cirrhosis of the liver, fibrosis, and lead to liver transplants. So what they found is that by using MOTS-c, they indicated that there was an improvement in insulin sensitivity, which was one of the first things you want to fix if you do have fatty liver disease. They also found that there is a reduction in the liver fat content. And they found that in this study that was published, they found that not only could this be beneficial for patients with NASH, but also with metabolic disease, which is what we've been talking about today in this video. And so the great thing about this is we've treated several clients who have NASH. Not only is MOTS-c important, but if you combine tesamorelin and ipamorelin, BPC-157, thymosin beta-4, you'll find that there's phenomenal transformations that can occur in the liver. And by the way, that includes the right exercise, the right nutrition, getting rid of the things that cause it in the first place, like the Doritos, the fried foods, you know, the French fries that we all love, the seed oils that are killing us, and just removing those things from your life, your body will love you and you'll feel so much better. And so for those of you who had enough compelling evidence to say, "I want to go deeper on MOTS-c, tell me more," I've got a video that I provided the link for you in the show notes below. Click on that link and I'll see you in the video all about MOTS-c. It's everything you ever wanted to know about this phenomenal peptide. I'm Regan Archibald. I'll see you there.